papers. Woohoo! What a week it's been in Europe. Champions League quarterfinals, two great solo performances from Messi and Ronaldo. In Turin, the demise of an old lady who wouldn't splash out on strikers. Trying to think of a topical parallel there, but nope, nothing. And of course, the incredible scenes at the Westfalen Stadium, Malaga's epic fail. 90 minutes gone, the Spanish side 2-1 up in a game even the old Man City would have thought twice about bottling, but instead ending crumpled on the turf while Borussia parted like it was 1999. Football bloody hell and all that. Was it, as Die Welt called it, a wonderful night of the yellow-black journey, or in the words of Malaga paper Sur, a robbery? Ref and UEFA gang up to stop us. Had, as Sir Deutscher put it, we seen glorious madness on the field, or just a dream, in the words of La Opinion de Malaga, that the referees turned into a nightmare? Well, the German papers were in no doubt. This was total football madness, to quote Berlin's Der Tagesspiegel. Generations to come will talk about this game. Bild call it the miracle of Dortmund, the craziest 3-2 since Bern, harking back, of course, to the 54 World Cup when the German national side came back from 2-0 down to beat Hungary 3-2 in Bern. Speaking of Hungary, Bild also have the story of the real victims of the night, spectators Udo Nebi and his daughter, who, in the 89th minute, left their seats to go and get a hot dog and ended up not seeing a sausage. Says a chastened Udo, "I was just disappointed. Two goals I had not expected. One thing I know for sure, this will never happen to me again." Well, it was the worst decision in a very real sense, although perhaps not as bad as Scottish referee Craig Thompson's, for whom Spanish paper AS has a special mention. "If they put Wolfgang Stark in the freezer for his errors," says AS, "Thompson should be sent to the North Pole. You executioner, you stealer of dreams." And the Malaga press, as you can imagine, agreeing. Malaga hoy here, inconsolable. "You can't do that. Europe trembles and weeps for you, Malaga," says their editorial. "And the pain is felt not just in our town, but across the five continents. This was one of the biggest cruelties in the history of sport. From the country that brought you bullfighting, that's certainly saying something. Never mind, eh? Because here's Marca to cheer everyone up. They say, yes, it was a historic act of cruelty, but we salute Manuel Pellegrini, who once again has worked miracles in the Champions League. Many thanks to his team for the passions that they have inspired." And ooh, meanwhile, back in AS, here's good old Thomas Roncero announcing, "Brothers of Malaga, we will avenge you. Borussia, we're waiting, waiting in the semi-finals." We, in this instance, being a Roncero's true love, Real Madrid, who are through to the semis themselves, after a bit of a scare against Galatasaray, the Turks scoring three goals in 15 minutes for a 3-2 win. It wasn't enough to see them through, but it was enough for top Turkish journal Fotomac to do another of their specials. Here's Ronaldo laid out a hit and run, saying, "Anyone get the number of that truck? Yes, we hit them hard. We ran them down," said the paper. "Rarely have Real looked this powerless. Well done, Galatasaray." We have to feel a bit for Ronaldo, who scored two absolutely fantastic goals in that game in Turkey, dragging Madrid through, as AS put it, but who still gets overshadowed this week by Leo Messi again in his second leg, using only his first. 60 minutes gone in the game with Paris Saint-Germain, Barcelona trailing 1-0, Messi brought on, and at that moment, as L'Equipe put it, hope left town. Or rather, as AS had it, hope changed sides, fear settling on the shoulders of Zlatan and co. Messi didn't actually score himself, but he didn't need to, said the papers. The Argentine's arrival galvanised the side, scaring the opposition and leading almost immediately to the equaliser. El Mundo Deportivo. Espíritu Messi, 10% of him is worth 100 of most players. Sport to the semis. They say Messi fit is the best player in the world, and the second best player in the world is Messi half fit, and so on and so forth. El País even suggesting this week that one day Barcelona will win a game simply by fielding a cardboard cutout of him. Don't know, hasn't worked with Torres. Well, Paris Saint-Germain then go home with their heads high, and Barcelona Real go through, as do Bayern and Borussia. It's an interesting international matchup shaping up in the semis. Two Germans, two Spanish, and Marca this week saying, Bunda against Liga. Who really is in charge here? Well, I guess we'll see when those semis get underway in a couple of weeks' time. Meantime, that's it for today's paper review. We'll be back with more news in the interim next Friday. Do make sure you join us then.